This is the joy for me. I love bread. I love bread.
Don't we all? Oprah knows what's up. Breads have gotten a bad rap when it comes to eating healthy and losing weight, but sliced breads are now trying to find their way into the nutrition department with claims like double fiber, fiber-rich, high protein. So Molly Kimball is here to break it all down with her love it, like it, hate it picks. We all love bread.
We all love bread. I feel like that. You asked if I've been to one restaurant that has like particularly good bread, and they do it in the bread in a brick oven.
Yeah.
Like I could crawl in that oven with the bread.
Yes. You know, I just live there.
Bread is my thing. It's, you know, you said yours is more pasta.
Yeah.
And everybody has their thing, but if bread is your thing, then you know, okay, sometimes it's even as much as there's certain bread you don't keep at home because it's too hard to keep portions
in check. Anything from boulangerie, I can't keep at home. It's so good.
Exactly.
Okay, so a lot of these breads now have these fiber-rich claims, protein-rich claims. Some kind of hold up to those claims more than others.
Exactly. So we had a viewer who said, I'm seeing these things that are touting themselves as protein bread, fiber bread. What's the deal? Because they're all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is, there's really no standard definition that's governing these terms. So these can be added to products that really aren't all that great.
Mm-hmm.
There's not like a legal definition.
Okay.
So when we're looking at what do you want to look for bread, we still want to stick with, we want to go 100% whole grain as much as possible, limiting our enriched wheat flour. Now, if you're putting meats into a sandwich, if you're making a sandwich with your turkey, with whatever type of protein, we don't really need a protein bread when
mm-hmm.
we're going to be using that for a sandwich. What I look at more there is, let's keep our carbs down, let's keep our calories down when we're using two slices, especially, of course, if your goal is weight loss or weight control. Now, when you're using a bread for breakfast, a slice of toast, or you're having it as part of a snack, that's when it really does matter because you may be having it as a standalone.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's where we start to look at, okay, every little bit can matter as mm-hmm. far as that protein keeping us fuller longer and the fiber.
Okay.
There's not a lot of options in our Lovitz.
No. Well, and there are two options. We just can't show one of them because it's mail order only.
Exactly. So this is paleo bread, and this is one that you can get in stores. We have it here locally at Rouse's. You can find it at Whole Foods. This is in the freezer section.
Mm-hmm.
And why I like this bread is that it has almost as much protein as carbs. So each slice of bread has 7 grams of protein and only 8 grams of carbs.
Wow.
Typical slice of bread has about 15 grams of carbs and about half that of protein. And we're looking at about 5 grams of fiber. The other brand, and again, we have this on WGNO.com, is P28 protein bread. So two slices of that, 28 grams of protein and only 24 grams of carbs, and that's in two slices. That's why they call it P28 bread.
Got it.
Okay. Those are two options that I would say are great. The P28, you can order it on Amazon or you can order it from their website. I tried to get it to have it to show y'all today, but didn't get it in time. So
okay, that's
we'll just
all
imagine
right.
that.
And one thing we should note, this is, if you're kind of a traditional bread person, might not be up your alley. It's
right.
kind of for those diehard protein
and
people.
And you can see the loaf even looks different.
Yeah.
And the ingredients in here has got coconut flour, egg whites, so there's also an almond flour version. These are also gluten-free, I should add.
Okay.
And so it's a denser, smaller slice. So if you're a bread connoisseur, this might not keep you happy.
Might not be for you.
But in the Likets, we do have some options. Now, these aren't as much protein breads, but these do have that fiber claim, that double fiber claim. Now, what I'll say about the double fiber breads, there's nothing wrong with these. And in fact, this Nature's Own double fiber wheat is what I recommend to a lot of people for sandwiches because it's only 50 calories a slice.
That's great, yeah.
Or if you're going to top this with some cheese, with some peanut butter, with some avocado for breakfast or a snack, fantastic. It's not a big calorie commitment, only 50 calories a slice. The way that a lot of these breads bump the fiber up, though, is with chicory root or with inulin. These are basically isolated fibers that don't have that same nutritional benefit that true whole grains do. So you've got a low-calorie whole grain bread, but it's not really double all the health benefits.
Okay.
The numbers ratcheted up on the label, but that's it.
Okay. And what's next?
What's next? This is the Oro Wheat Health Nut. So this one doesn't necessarily have the blatant double fiber claims on it, but the name alone, Health Nut,
yeah.
I always like to point out this is a perfect example of what not to do. So the first ingredient, enriched wheat flour, which is of course just white flour. We also have honey in it, we have molasses in it. So this is one that people would reach for and say, wow, this is fantastic. It looks so seedy and grainy.
Yeah.
Twice the calories of that Nature's Own double fiber that we were just looking at, and again, white flour, not the way that we want to start our day.
Okay, and real quickly, what's coming up in our next segment? Breaking some myths?
Breaking some myths, and especially about bread. A lot of people say, you know, bread here, if I, you know, upsets my stomach, but if I travel to other countries, I can eat bread with no issues. What's the difference? So we've got what the difference is.
Okay, we'll talk about that coming up here on Good Morning New Orleans. Thanks, Molly.